As one of the most recognized hip-hop DJs in SA, Ms. Cosmo has quickly made her mark on the African continent as a hip-hop queen and gained widespread respect within the music and entertainment industry. Now, besides her producing skills, she also hosts one of the biggest music shows on 5FM. Her most popular single, titled Connect, which features rapper Nasty C, Rouge and Questa, has garnered over 1 million views on YouTube. Let's have a look. They count the net, I confess, I've been talking a little crazy. Oh, yeah. Me and all my homies, oh, yeah. Calling all the shots, oh, yeah. Barely calling home, no. Instagram captions, yeah, yeah. Preach when you tag me. Still go to church and pray to God and let me speak like I have. When we hold up, tools up, yeah. Then we burn a zip, I put my crew up. But my family first, I didn't connect with the stars and I float away. Tell me you're on the way. Just go straight till you see in heaven, then you call me up. I'm only a couple turns away. Ooh, yeah, I'm as young as they come. But my grow up is over. I'm sorry I rap a lot. I grew up the cold. I was raised by a rolling stone. That turned me into a rolling stone. And all you haters are getting me to pull the toe. When I'm supposed to pose up on the totem pole, I'm toe to toe with the devil. I blow the smoke in his face. I got the juice, the bevy. I had to give Noni a taste. Blowing O's and smoking J's. I think I just rolled me a case. I was quick with the come up. I didn't even put my foot on the bricks.
And it's none other than one of our Afternoon Express favorites, Miss Cosmo. We are obsessed with you.
Thank you.
Welcome to the show.
Thank you so much. I'm so happy to be here. It's my first time on Afternoon Express.
We just love you, and we've been trying so hard to get you, but you are busy, girl.
Yes, well, you know, trying to make money.
It's okay, we love money too. So congratulations on Connect. Firstly,
Thank you.
A great song.
Thank you so much.
You know, one of the best things I think about when you've been in the industry and you've been working, when you've been grafting and you've gotten respect from your peers because of the work that you do, you kind of get to pick and choose the people that you want to work with.
Yes, that's what.
And how did you obviously came up with the song Connect, and then how did you decide on who you were going to collaborate with?
With Connect, it was basically just my sitting down and saying, okay, who are my favorite rappers at the moment? Who do I think is actually going to do what I need on the song? Yeah. And obviously, Nasty C at the time when we actually recorded the song was like the hottest kid out.
He still is.
Wow. But he was still like up and coming at the time, so I got him early. At the time, I was quite excited to work with him. He was the new kid on the block. Rouge was also making such big waves as a female rapper. And of course, Questa, everybody loves Questa. So
incredible.
For me, it was just, okay, what is my wish list? What do I want the song to sound like? Who's going to do that for the song? And obviously, we have Connect.
It is just such a good song. A million views on YouTube. And I mean, there's good reason for it. It is unbelievable. And it's so, Pali and I were laughing, it's international.
Yeah.
Girl, it is just, it's like global quality. It's amazing. Can we just discuss the trajectory that Nasty C is on at the moment?
Amazing.
That guy is, he's our next global export.
Definitely. And if he stays around for too long, we're actually going to come and find him and tell him to leave.
Exactly. Now, you are just unbelievable. And as far as one of our favorite Afternoon Express women goes, it's because you've done so many firsts. You were there before any of our rappers.
Yes.
I mean, if you look at Sway in the morning, I mean, so for those of you who don't know, it's basically like the hottest hip-hop radio show in the States. And when a hip-hop artist makes it, they get interviewed on Sway. You were the first one in South Africa to be on Sway.
Yes,
How did that happen?
I was actually out in New York at the time. I was actually going on holiday, but obviously trying to make a few connections. I mean, being in hip-hop, New York is like the pinnacle of where hip-hop actually kind of started. So you want to get out there. You want to make those connections. So I went out there, obviously spoke to a few people. A friend of mine, DJ Supernova, did the connect for me, and I went through and I did a mix, which was really awesome. Yeah. And I think that also kind of opened up the gates for the rest of the South African rappers to actually head on over to Sway, which was really awesome. So I'm happy I was part of that.
You are talented, you're beautiful, but you're also like ridiculously clever. So I want to know about, you went from working in a bank to then becoming like the hip hop queen. what was that jump?
That jump was because I guess at the time I didn't really know what I wanted to do. You know, after matric, you know, you sit down, you're like, okay, what am I going to do? Am I going to go study? Am I going to go into music? I wasn't really sure. So for me, it was just the easy option. Okay, go to school, study finance, get a job, get married, you know what I mean, and continue.
Safe,
but then
safe.
But then at some point, I was just like, no, man, there's something missing. There's something I really want to do. And obviously, music has always been my passion since I was a child. Yeah. Obviously, like performing in front of the TV, learning dance moves and things like that. So eventually somebody, well, a friend of mine actually suggested that I take DJ lessons because I used to make compilations that I used to play in my car and I'd take them to Bry's and all this stuff and they'd always enjoy them. So I was like, okay. And my friend was like, no, man, you've got an ear for music. Maybe you should take some lessons. So I took DJ lessons and long story short, I'm here now and left the bank and, and I'm still happy,
But you can't, you're not just a like, kick-ass producer and DJ, but you can sing as well.
Well, yeah, that's a new thing.
singing on your music is a new thing, but I mean, tell me about that. Did you just decide, oh, I can't find a good enough vocalist?
No.
Just lay down myself.
I wish. No. It wasn't even the case. I mean, I'd been singing for a while. I mean, I was in the choir when I was in high school. I actually performed at my school talent show, some things that people didn't really know about. But outside of that, the reason why I actually jumped on the single wasn't intentional. Yeah. I was in studio with the guys with my new single. It was Cuesta, Kid X Solo. And at the time, they needed like a bit of a reference as to how they're going to write their verses. Yeah. So we wrote the chorus and then they were like, okay, just sing it. I like whatever you do, just sing it and then we'll work on it after that. And after I sang, they were like, okay, well, we're not getting anybody else. You have to stay. And they literally bullied me to re-record and to stay on the song. And amazing. Well, we're here now.
Had I sung it, it would have been a very different song. Now, your show on 5FM is huge.
Yes.
There's nobody who doesn't listen to it. But, I mean, where do you find all the hours in the day? Like, I think everybody else has got 24 hours in the day. You and Beyonce have got a different time.
You know what? You use every single minute, every single second. You find the time. That's basically what you do. Yeah.
But now, I believe you've got your own playlist on what you play. Like, all other DJs, I know, even when I was on radio, you get a schedule on what you're going to play. But not you.
No.
You've got your own.
Yes. I have full reign over the show. I think that's one of the awesome things that 5FM has actually given me with regards to that, and it's also given me an opportunity to shine a light on up-and-coming artists, people who are actually trying to get their music out there, because I mean, being on the main playlist is one thing, but obviously still being able to hear your songs on radio is an achievement on its own. I mean, the likes of Nasty C, I was one of the first to actually play them on radio, so it's little things like that that kind of build a person's artistry and their confidence with their music, so I try to do that.
Now, I find it such a boring question when people ask you about being a woman in the hip-hop, because for me, you're a hip-hop DJ, you're not a female hip-hop DJ. You are a hip-hopper.
Yeah.
So, but was there, I mean, what kind of words of advice do you have for women who want to get into a traditionally male industry?
I think...
Did you struggle at all? Were you ever looked at differently?
In the beginning, yes, because it kind of looked like a bit of a gimmick. They were like, okay, well, can she really DJ? Yeah. Are there really skills? What is she actually doing? I mean, there's different spaces, there's different thoughts with regards to this game, because not only is DJing a boys' club, but hip-hop is a boys' club. So I was in a boys' club within a boys' club, so that was the difficult thing. But I think for me, it's all about hard work, it's about perseverance, it's about striving for what you want and not giving up, because I find a lot of girls who actually want to get into DJing, somehow at some point are like, this is too much work, this is too hard. You need to keep pushing if that's your passion, and I think the passion for music is what has kept me here, and that's why I've been able to leave the bank and actually make a career out of this, because I knew what I wanted out of it, and I keep striving for more.
And you've just got such courage of your own conviction, of your own talent. Like, sometimes I look at you, you know, because you've opened for so many other performers and you've shared stages with Kendrick Lamar, Kanye. Like, how do you, like, that's nerve-wracking. Like, what are your nerves like when you're looking out? I would panic. I'd need my asthma pump and then stop.
It's crazy. I won't lie to you. But all you got to think about is, okay, well, you're on stage now. There's nothing you can do about it. You can't turn back. You know what I mean? So you just got to kind of get it done. But opening for those big stages has been really monumental for my career. And I think I appreciate the fact that I was actually able to share those stages. One of my favorites was definitely opening for Kanye. I was able to also then just think outside the box. Because as a DJ, sometimes you just stand behind the decks and you play. And then people look at you like this. And then it's like, okay, what else is happening? So being on a stage like that allows me to then think outside the box, bring a dancers, bring a drama,
make it a show.
You know what I mean? Make it a show. The one time when I opened for 2 Chainz, I had a violinist. So for me, it's always an opportunity for me to try something different, you know?
What's your next, like, major gig?
Well, I I don't know. Durban, July, I guess, this weekend.
Yeah, amazing.
But over and above that, I'm actually trying to get myself out into the rest of the world. Okay. So I am going to Europe in August. Hopefully that's going to solidify more context for me and do more things. Yeah.
Amazing. When you do open for Eminem, and you will eventually, you know,
okay.
You know, Jeannie D is changing the name to Jeannie D Mathers.
Okay.
So you need to hook it up for me, girl. Thank you for being here. I'm looking forward to your performance a little bit later.
Thank you so much for having me.